Good morning. I am driving this morning to my mom's house. It's Valentine's Day. This is my first vlog back as an active member of society. And this is MsBriParker TV.
Enjoy.
But it's okay because we are vlogging. I am so tired this morning. My body's so tired this morning that I can't even like get enough energy to just like do normal things. And I hate lupus for that because all I want to do is like run up the stairs, run down the stairs, and get my stuff done in the morning. But it's so difficult because my energy levels are so down. But it's all good. We're gonna have a quick time prayer this morning. I'm actually gonna get to my mom first so that I can be in agreement with her this morning. But yeah, so we're on our way to my mommy's, and then I'm going to the gym this morning. I'm going to AquaFit class, which is my therapy for my joint pain, for the joint pain. I don't say my joint pain because I am not my circumstances. Okay. So that I can function better in life. And I love it because my gym has, of course, classes. That you could take to, you know, take whatever, like AquaFit. I take yoga. I took my first yoga class like a couple weeks ago, and it was hilarious because that yoga teacher was definitely a little too fast for your girl. But I'm going back. I'm not about to be like I'm a quitter. No quitting. So I'm gonna go back. But it's Valentine's Day. You can see my red bag in the back. That's my gym bag. That's my baby. I am at my mom's, and hopefully we're about to pray right now because I gotta go to my class. I gotta go to my class. Yes. It's kind of weird. It feels like my skin is about to flare up. I did this facial on my face. I did this facial, and it was bacon soda and tea tree oil with a tad bit of water, and I rubbed it all over my face, and of course I felt the tea tree oil working, but at the same time it was like when I took it off, when I got in the shower and I washed my face and everything, it felt so good, and my face still feels good. And I actually did that like 5 days ago, so it actually worked and it feels good. But I gotta do it again, and you can see the shine in my face. I did not put any moisturizer on my face this morning, and I don't recall putting any on last night before I went to bed. But I still gotta get all this stuff, like my mustache and stuff. You know, women get mustaches too. So yeah, today's gonna be a good day. And my mom needs to come in here so we could pray. I should go get some cereal this morning. Mother, I bought you a box of cereal.
You bought me?
I brought you a box.
Oh, thank you.
It is.
I really appreciate that.
Seriously hot in this house.
It's real hot. I'm trying to go back in my room. I gotta stir my grits up. It's devil hot.
Pretty hot in this thing. It's pretty hot in this thing, like chicken wing. Mom, it's way too hot for that. Do you have any other cereal open?
No.
This is my warrior. in her jammies. She just got off work. She works from 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. Say hi.
Hi.
Say we're walking and healing, huh?
We're walking and healing. Yes, we are. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, yes. We are.
So we're about to go pray.
Yes.
Okay, I'm freezing. I'm always cold. I'm always cold. I'm leaving now to go to my class. We had our prayer. I had a little bit of breakfast this morning. And now I am heading to my class. So I'm really excited because I've been trying to make this class for a very long time. And I've had like doctor's appointments, and I've had like just too much going on to even get to the class, or my body would just be really tired and I couldn't make it. So with that being said, I would miss the class, and today I will not miss it. I don't care if it's Valentine's Day, your girl is single as a Pringle. Not really ready to mingle, so I am like wisdom and understanding when it comes to people doing things that they shouldn't do. I'm not the type of person to do whatever it takes to get what I need at that moment. I always try to think about things in the long run because it can come back to like haunt you if you don't do right. I was teaching my son about two different things, integrity and listening. I don't know why, but we can hear people and not listen, and it'll like come back to haunt us. If we're not listening to what you're saying, I hear you. You hear me talking right now. You hear me speaking. But you're not listening. And I can easily say something like, you know, your man is cheating on you. But you heard what I said, but you didn't listen to what I said. And I keep talking. I keep going over and over and over. Continuing with the conversation. But you heard me, but you didn't listen. So you finally say, oh, shoot, wait. Did she just say what I thought she said? So I'm currently reading this book by Richard Branson called The Virgin Way, which is the story of leadership and his story of leadership and how important it is to listen. So he talks about, you know, taking notes with everything and just doing all that kind of stuff. And I thought it was so important because if we don't listen, we won't catch the needs of people and fulfill them. And that was like a very important thing that I'm trying to get my son to understand, because if you're not listening and you hear me, you're gonna get in trouble. Like, it's just, it is what it is. You're gonna be in a lot of trouble. So he's learning to listen, and he'll say, yes mommy, and say, did you hear me? Yes, are you listening? Yes mommy. And it's a blessing, but at the same time, it's just funny because he's starting to catch on and get it. And so I have some syrup on my finger. Anyway, so yeah, praise the Lord. I got me a parking space right in the front. Hallelujah. So yeah, but the integrity thing, I had taught him the other day. I was telling him, be integral. Do what's right even when no one is watching. Even when you see that $100 on the ground and it's just in a facility, in a place, give it to the person and let them do with it. Do what they want with it, because if you don't, you don't know whose it is. Or somebody's credit card, or somebody's shoes, or somebody's whatever it is, that does not mean that it's automatically yours. And some people believe that, but those people to me are trolls, because you shouldn't think like that. If you didn't buy it, it's not yours. If you found it,
you know, there's just different circumstances. And I told him, you know, do what's right even when no one is looking. Be integral. And it's funny because Disneyland, when I was working at Disneyland, they taught me that. And that's a very big company. Oh, shoot. That's a very big company to work for. So it was very vital that I took heed of that, because it was like, okay, you have to be integral. You want people to trust you. You want God to trust you. You know, just be right, you know? I'm gonna head into this, my gym, and start my class. It's really crowded, and I was hoping that it wasn't crowded because it's Valentine's Day. Y'all should have been trying to get your booties right last week. Not this week. It's too late. So whatever lingerie y'all planning on wearing, it's not going to look right because y'all trying to get in the gym today. No. I think my sister said that they're having classes, couples classes, which would be really cute. So we're going to go see and look, see what that mushy love stuff looks like. I'm going to put my shoes on. My Tenta shoes. Really don't have to, only because I'm gonna be getting in the water, so I probably should not put my tennis shoes on and just wear my, I had socks on with sandals like an Asian person. So yeah, I'm gonna go on this thing. Have my class. I'm so excited. And I'm on time. So, yeah. We're gonna go in. Let's go in.
Oh gosh, I don't even have that much boobs in real life. I'm waiting for the class to start with some really nice young women, and yeah, I'm excited because this is my first time taking a class. I probably should take my rings off. Crap. Yeah, but we'll see. I can show you around the pool without showing anybody else. This is what the pool looks like. It's pretty big. Pretty big thing. I don't like when they do that. Give tours and men can come to the women's side of the... I don't know. That's weird to me. But...
Woo! Oh my god. I am finally out of the gym. And that was amazing. Really excited. I had the heat on earlier. It's hot now. I'm really excited because that was an awesome class. I needed that. I feel good. My chest is not hurting as bad as it does on a regular. Because my blood pressure is kind of low all the time. So I feel really good. The teacher was really, really nice. She wasn't like really fast and extra hardcore and all this kind of stuff. So that was awesome. Now I got a protein shake and I brought my bone broth protein and put it in the shake because I didn't want to not take it. So I got a chocolate banana shake with bone broth protein. Oh my god, I cannot say that all at once. Chocolate banana shake with bone broth protein two scoops of the bone broth protein, so it should be pretty good. I already had some in a little cup, and I actually let some other women try it because they were like, what is that? And I'm like, it's bone broth protein, and it heals your gut and helps your immune system. And she was like, oh my god, so can I? Excuse me, I was interrupted by my mama. Yeah, so it's really good. And excuse me, it's not an acquired taste, it's actually just a good taste. So it's not like, oh, you have to like it, or you have to have a certain palate for it. No, it's pretty good. So that's what I'm enjoying. We are going to go see my cousin, who I have not seen in ages. After my aunt passed away last year, he's really going through it right now. So my mom and my aunt and I are gonna go visit him at his house and try to get him together and see what he's going through, because we really, really, really don't want him to go through any more depression or anything like that. And he's one of my favorite cousins. So we're just not leaving my cousin's house. We have to get him moved out. He lost his mom, my aunt, last year, and he's going through it really bad, but who doesn't when you lose a parent? Now we've got some of his stuff to help him move. It's amazing what a man cannot do without a woman, but we are their ribs. We come from them. Yeah, that is crazy. But you know what? The best thing is that we have family. We have family to keep us covered and keep us prayed up and keep us loved. Because if we didn't, we in the streets. So, yeah. We're going to be coming back here to help him move and get him revived. And get him back to who my cousin Reggie is. Because I'm not feeling this at all. Like, for real. When you haven't shaved your armpits in a long time, you gotta improvise. I'm gonna grab some oranges. Grab some more oranges.
You got the car down here. What kind of meatball is this?
Ugh. Whoa. Y'all wanna see something real quick?
What the heck?
That's animal. Yeah, that is not real.
What in the world is that? What is that?
I don't know. That's an animal.
That's like a cat. Something got towed. Oh,
yeah.
I'm cool. I am cool. That is scary. Let me pick some of these oranges. Because they are going to waste. Okay. Letting nature's fruit go to nature's candy. Huh? Ugh. This is gonna be hard because this is broke out. You see, I want those ones right there. Look how beautiful those are. I don't have tennis shoes on. If I have tennis shoes on. It's gorgeous. Such beautiful. Let's see, that one is too small. I think that's going to be it. Got about five more. I'm
loving how the light is like coming in. Look at that camera. Look at that on there.
Oh my gosh. It's life.
Beautiful life. Look at that one too.
Okay. I got a phone call, but I got some oranges. So I'm excited. I'm about to drink my water, put some more sunscreen on because it's hot right now, and I'll be like this tomorrow. So that's what I'm gonna do. And then I'm gonna go home. And I'm acting like I don't have a child to get it 2:30. And yeah, see you later. What's up, guys? I totally did not vlog the majority of my day because I was too busy being a mom. And I didn't give that part of my day up. I need to get things done pronto. So now I am getting ready to settle down. All the way down. I'm tired. Probably not sleepy, but tired to get enough energy to do all the other things that I need to do as far as meal prepping. So, yeah. I need some.